Congress don't want to fix it because Congress want to hand this president a fail. It's all about anti-Trump agenda, anti-law enforcement agenda.
Would failing to build the wall, as he's promised, be a fail for this president?
Absolutely. And I think what's really disappointing, I had an interview this morning, I expect a lot of the left to fight it, even though a lot of them supported it a few years ago under a different president. But there's some in our own party and the Republican Party that is not supporting the president with funding the border wall. And that's sad because, as I said earlier, 34 years doing this, every place they built a wall or barrier, it worked. Illegal migration dropped significantly, 100% effective. Why would we not want it? If it saves lives, slows down the drugs coming across, slows down illegal immigrants coming across, why would you not want it? So yeah, I think this president gets it. Look, the first couple meetings I had with the president, I sat there and listened. He understands this issue. So he spent a lot of time being educated on it, or someone's advising him very well. He gets it. He has the right plan. But he's being prevented from putting that plan in place because he needs Congress's help to do it. He has law enforcement. They're shoulder to shoulder with him. But we need action by Congress to make his plan a reality.
But there are so many Republicans who are not behind it, who talk about it when they campaign. And I won't mention them by name, but I have several on a list that I watch on a daily basis who, as they're campaigning, are going to talk about border enforcement, they're going to talk about border security, but they always dance around the wall issue because they don't want to promise to support the wall because they know they're not going to. How do we get to a place where Republicans, some, no longer care about border enforcement, immigration law enforcement in general? What's the motivation?
I think they realize it's a very politically sensitive issue. It's an emotional issue.
But this president won on that issue. That's what I guess I don't understand, is Republicans will campaign on it, but then when it comes time to vote on it, to fund it, they back away. I don't understand what their motivation is.
I think the motivation is to be reelected. They don't want, they're afraid of votes. And I think they read too much of the left side of media. I don't believe these polls that say Americans don't support the wall. I think most Americans do. I think most Americans they believe in a sovereign country and they think we have a right to protect our borders. Listen, I'm an old guy. And like I said, I grew up in a small town upstate New York. The America I grew up in, people respected law enforcement. People respected the office of the president. People didn't kneel for the national anthem. We finally have a president that wants to get back to that America. I can't believe everybody's not behind it, considering what he's trying to do. So shows like this, your listeners, they need to call their congressman and senator. If they don't think they're supporting this agenda, especially the Republicans who campaign on it, call them on it. So where are you at with sanctuary cities legislation? Where are you at with closing the loopholes like Florida Settlement Agreement and family detention? Where are you at with building the wall? It's going to be up to the voters to call out their representatives and where they're at on this issue. Put pressure on them.